Myself, Dr. S. Momageshwari, Head, Department of Management Studies. Now I am going to explain the subject Human Resource Management for BBACE. In this subject, in this session especially, we are going to study about the meaning of HRM, definitions of HRM, functions and scope of HRM, finally strategic human resource management. Let me see one by one. The first one is the human resource management meaning. Human resource management is the practice of recruiting, hiring, deploying and managing an organization's employees. HRM is often referred to simply as human resource company or organization's HR department is usually responsible for creating, putting into effect and overseeing policies governing workers and the relationship of the organization with its employees. The next important meaning of human resource management is, human resource management is the term used to describe formal systems devised for the management of people within an organization. The responsibilities of a human resource manager fall into three areas: staffing, employee compensation, and benefits, and designing work. Essentially, the purpose of human resource management is to maximize the productivity of an organization by optimizing the effectiveness of its employees. The next one is nature of human resource management. It be defined as the total knowledge, skills, creative abilities, talents and aptitudes of an organization's workforce, as well as the values, attitudes, approaches and beliefs of the individuals involved in the affairs of the organization. It is the sum total of aggregate of inherent abilities, acquired knowledge and skills represented by the talents and aptitudes of the persons employed in the organization. Human resources are multidimensional in nature. From the national point of view, human resources may be defined as the knowledge, skills, creative abilities, talents and aptitude obtained in the population. Whereas from the viewpoint of the individual enterprise, they represent the total of the inherent abilities, acquired knowledge and skills as exemplified in the talents and aptitudes of its employees. The next one is the nature of human resource management. Human resource management is the process of bringing people and organizations together so that the goals of each are met. The various features are, it's pervasive in nature as it is presented in all enterprises. It is focused on results rather than on rules. It tries to help employees develop their potential fully. It encourages employees to give their best to the organization. HRM, it is all about people at work, both as individuals and groups. It tries to put people on assigned jobs in order to produce good results. It helps an organization meet its goals in the future by providing for competent and well-motivated employees. It tries to build and maintain cordial relations between people working at various levels in the organization. Next, we have to see about the scope of human resource management. So the first scope is manpower planning. Manpower planning means determining the number and kind of personnel required to fill various positions in the organizations. Recruitment, selection, placement of personnel. The third scope is training and development of employees. The performance appraisal of the employee is the fourth important scope of human resource management. Motivating the employees by providing them proper financial and non-financial incentives is the important scope of human resource management. Then social and welfare securities of the employees, audit of personal policies, procedures and practices of the organization. These are the seven very important scopes of human resource management. The next one is objectives of human resource management. The first and the foremost important objective is organizational objective. What is that? HRM is a means to achieve efficiency and effectiveness. It serves other functional areas so as to help them to attain efficiency in their operations and attainment of goals to attain efficiency. Acquiring right man for the right job at the right time in right quantity. Developing through right kind of training, utilizing the selected workforce and maintaining the workforce are the organizational objectives of HRM. Succession planning is an important issue to be taken up as a contemporary organizational objective. The second objective of HRM is functional objectives. HRM performs so many functions for other departments. However, it must see that the facilitation should not cost more than the benefit rendered. The third objective is personal objectives. In today's world, there is shortage of requisite talent. Employees are encouraged by competitive firms to change the jobs. HRM has the responsibility to acquire, develop, utilize and maintain employees. This would be possible only when the HRM helps employees to achieve their personal goals to get more commitment. Creating work-life balance for the employee is one of the personal objective. The next objective is social objective. HRM must see that the legal, ethical and social environmental issues are properly attended to. Equal opportunity and equal pay for equal work are the legal issues not to be violated. To take care of farmers whose land has been acquired for the factory and tribals who are displaced by industries and mining companies are the ethical issues. The results are clear when these issues are not taken care of. To help the society through generating employment opportunity, creating schools and dispensaries, helping women empowerment are the social responsibilities issues. The next topic we will see about the functions of human resource management. So the functions can be divided into different categories. Let me see, the first function is managerial functions. So managerial functions include, the first one is planning. One of the primary functions where number and type of employees needed to accomplish organizational goals and determine. Research firms co-HRM planning, which also helps management to collect, analyze and identify current plus future needs within the organization. Second managerial function is organizing. Organization of the task is another important step. Task is allocated to every member as per their skills and activities are integrated towards a common goal. The third managerial functions are directing. This includes activating employees at different levels and making them contribute maximum towards organizational goal. Tapping maximum potentialities of an employee via constant motivation and commands is a prime focus. The fourth one is post-planning, organizing and directing. Performance of an employee is checked, verified and compared with goals. If actual performance is found deviated from the plan, control measures are taken. The second objectives, second functions of the human resource management is operative functions. What are that? Operative functions include recruitment or hiring. Hiring is a process which brings pool of prospective candidates who can help organization achieve their goals and allows management to select right candidates from the given pool. The second operative function is job analysis and design. Describing nature of the job like qualification, skill, work experience required for specific job position is another important operative task. Whereas job design include outlining tasks, duties and responsibilities into a single work unit to achieve certain goal. Checking and analyzing employees' performance is another important function that human resource management has to perform. The another function is training and development. This function allows employees to acquire new skills and knowledge to perform their job effectively. Training and development also prepares employees for high-level responsibilities. The next one is salary administration. Human resource department also determines pays for different jobs and include compensation, incentives, bonus, benefits, etc. related with their job function. The another functions of human resource management is employee welfare. This function takes care of numerous services, benefits and facilities provided to an employee for their well-being. The seventh benefit is maintenance. So minimizing employee turnover and sustaining best performing employees within the organization is the key. Minimizing return on investments with human resource department is also a key goal for human resource management team. The eighth function of human resource management is labor relations. Labor relation is regards to the workforce who work within a trade union. Employees in such domain form a union or group to voice their decisions effectively to the higher management. The next function is personal research. Research is a vital part of human resource management. It is performed to keep a check on employee opinion about wages, promotions, work condition, welfare activities, leadership, employee satisfaction, and other key issues. The last function is personal record. This function involves recording, maintaining, and retrieving employees' related information, including employment history, work hours, earning history, etc. Next, we are going to study about the roles and responsibilities of HR manager. The first one is attract talent. Attracting talent starts with first planning the recruitment of manpower in the organization. Gauging needs of the organization's human resource requirements and accordingly putting a plan of action to fulfill these needs with the placement of your talented professionals. That's followed by creating an employer brand, which will be representative of the organization's good image and portray an attractive impression in the minds of potential candidates. The employer branding aspects have become very important owing to the new age media and awareness of employee rights. Putting the best foot forward is no longer enough. It needs to be followed through with honest action in favor of the employees. And finally, the HR manager needs to create detailed recruitment strategies to carry out the hiring process. The next one is, next important role of HR manager is hire resources. This is where the recruitment strategies are put into action. In the current age, there is a ton of competition vying for the attention of the best talent in the market. The HR manager needs to run all possible engines to go out there is in market and find that one suitable game. This part of the role includes things like finding relevant locations to look in, reach out to maximum potential candidates, using mass communication mediums, aggregate all responses, filter out irrelevant applications, judge suitable incumbents, and coordinate internally to get them interviewed. Once the finalists are decided, the HR manager turns into a negotiator of sorts, working as a mediator between the company and the candidate to find that win-win ground. The next role is training. Not all is done once you have recruited a suitable candidate for the job. Many organizations perform tasks a tad differently. It is imperative for the HR department to incorporate a training program for every new employee based on the skill set required for the job. It will further also contribute to employee motivation and retention. For the training to be effective, every new employee can be subjected to an on-the-job training or off-the-job training for the initial days to get him in sync with the work guidelines of the organization. This training will not only be of assistance to the employee but also give the HR team an insight into the employee's workmanship. On completion of the training, HR plays a significant role in assessing the results of the training program and grading employees on the same. The next one is, the next important role and responsibility of HRM is professional development. Closely related to training, developing your employees professionally is an added bonus for the employee as well as the organization. Enrolling the employee to attend conferences, trade shows, seminars, etc. that may be in his personal interest will make the employee feel cared for, a vital part of the organization, thus increasing employees' engagement. It will be beneficial to the organization by the way of the employee's added skills set. In short, it is a win-win. It is the HR head's job to get to know the employee's hobbies and areas of interest and look out for opportunities that will help them build onto those hobbies. For example, if an employee wants to master the technique of SEO, HR could enroll him for seminars and conferences that talk on the same. However, this should not turn out to be the selfish attempt that benefits of the organization only. The next one is appraisal function, appraisal role. Since human resource management is a body meant for the employees, carrying out timely performance appraisal is a given. Performance appraisals helps in employee motivation by encouraging them to work to their fullest potential. It also enables to give them feedback on their work and suggest necessary measures for the same. This helps employees to have a clear view of what is expected of them and what they are delivering. They can thus work better towards improving their performance and achieving targets. The role of human resource manager in this would be to have a policy of generating timely appraisal reports and a review of the same by the authorities. The HR team should communicate individually with employees and give clear feedback or suggestions on their performance. A system to reward employees excelling at their work would help in employee motivation and thus garner a higher degree of productivity and employee engagement. The next one important role is maintaining work culture. It is the duty of the HR to maintain a healthy, safe, and fun work environment to ensure a level of comfort amongst the employees and eliminate any stressful or awkward atmosphere that may hinder the performance of the staff. It is vital to have an efficient work atmosphere because of an individual's performance largely depends on the surroundings he is working in. It would be great to have an open door policy to some extent wherein employees can freely communicate and voice their opinions to be given consideration. The HR department's role is to be a friendly body with an open attitude. By communicating and treating every employee as equal, HR can build a rapport with the employees. This goes a long way in increasing employee engagement and gives a higher job satisfaction. The next one is resolving conflict. Where different people have different views of conflicts are almost inevitable. Whether the dispute is among us two or more employees or between the employee and the management, an HR manager has the right to intervene and help map out a solution. The HR should be available at the disposal of the conflicting parties and hear out their issues without being judgmental. Prior investigation are a must before passing any judgment. The HR head is not expected to discriminate or play favorite in this matter and always deliver an unbiased and practical decision. A reimbursement in case of any loss caused and strict actions against the defaulter should be practiced for effective conflict resolution by the HR management. The next role is employees relation. Human resource is called so because its major responsibility is dealing with the human part of the organization. And this involves having great interpersonal skills. An HR manager who sits in the office all day will not turn out to be good at building connections with the employees and thus fail to serve the purpose of being an HR head. As an HR person, employees should feel comfortable coming up to you with their problems, and for that, it's important that the HR team builds a good public image within the organization. The HR team has to be proactive and know their employees. An employee's HR personnel's job is not a desk job altogether. The HR head's role is to establish the trust and confidence of the employees and not have a don't mess with me demeanor. He should be looked upon as both an HR expert and an employee advocate. The next one is rewards and incentives. In this rewards, rewarding the employees for their work well done imparts motivation and at the same time induces a desire to excel at task in hope of obtaining rewards. It serves as bait for inculcating a healthy competitive environment among employees to achieve target and meet deadlines. A reward need not be materialistic always. It could just be a word of appreciation in front of all co-workers for a menial task done with a completely honest. The next two important role and responsibility is legal knowledge. This may seem the least glamorous of all, but is an important aspect of the HRM. An HR manager should always be in compliance with the law. Whether it's drafting new policies or writing term of a contract, it is the HR department's jobs to build the guidelines keeping the laws in mind. This ensures an organization's continued growth and existence. While drafting policies, the HR should always ensure to be at an upper hand legally and keep the organization's practice in true with the labor laws, tax laws, permissible working hours, minimum wages, and a no discrimination policy. The next one is organization. An HR head is responsible for organizing all functions of the organization. To start with, it includes employee onboarding, that is welcoming new employees. It is a must for every HR head to carry out induction for every new hire and give them an orientation regarding the company policies and rules. The HR personnel should also introduce the new employees to their colleagues and assign them a mentor. It also involves listening out job expectations and defining roles and responsibilities. Thus, getting the new employees in tune with the working of the organization. The HR personnel are also responsible for organizing and storing all employee data efficiently and keeping it secure. Another important responsibility is management. Management is the most important job of an HR manager. It is what defines a good HR manager. Management extends right from managing employees to managing the employers and the whole HR department as well. The role of an HR manager is to manage, create, implement and supervise policies, regulations, which are mandatory for every employee and also have knowledge of its appropriate functioning. Mentoring attendance and tracking leaves forms a major chunk of the HR management function. There should be a proper management of the clocking out time to avoid late arrivals and to track overtimes and off days. As mentioned before, the HR as a department should also be well managed by the HR head. If the HR department itself is in a state of chaos, it cannot serve as a peacemaker for the other department. Finally, we will study about the strategic human resource management. Strategic human resource management is the practice of attracting, developing, rewarding, and retaining employees for the organization as a whole. Human resource department that practice strategic human resource management do not work independently within a silo. They interact with other departments within an organization in order to understand their goal and then create strategies that align with those objectives as well as those of the resources department reflect and support the goal of the rest of the organization. Strategic human resource management is seen as a partner in organizational success as opposed to a necessity for legal compliances or compensation. Strategic HRM utilize the talent and opportunity within the human resource department to make other department stronger and more effective. Okay, so far we studied in this session the introduction about the human resource management, meaning, definitions and the functions of HRM we studied, then the roles and responsibilities. Finally, we studied a strategic human resource management. Thank you.